Datadog is a platform that empowers you to effectively monitor and analyze various aspects of your system. In this video, I will demonstrate how to effortlessly observe logs on your Linux machine. To begin, you should create a DatadogHQ account. During the registration process, it's recommended to select the region that is geographically closest to your location, although it's not that significant. Once your registration is complete, you will be provided with installation instructions. Simply navigate to the left-hand side of the screen and select your operating system. Then proceed to follow the instructions provided. I rented a new VPS from DigitalOcean. If you are interested, you can also register your account on DigitalOcean and receive $200 credit for 60 days by using the referral link provided in the video's description. It's a great opportunity to try out DigitalOcean services and explore what they have to offer. Just click on the referral link in the description to get started. Once you've logged into the server, you will need to copy and paste the command provided in the instructions. After executing the command, you will need to patiently wait until the installation of the Datadog agent is completed. Once the installation is complete, we can verify the status of the Datadog agent. While the Datadog agent itself is running, it seems that the log agent is not currently active. To enable the log agent, we will need to make modifications to the etc Datadog agent datadog.yaml file, uncomment and set logs enabled value to true. Then restart the agent. When you switch back to the agent setup page, you will be greeted with a message congratulating you on the successful installation of your first agent. Now let's proceed with adding our first log file to monitor. As new log entries are appended to the file, the log agent will send those messages to Datadog, where you will be able to view the logged events. However, before we proceed, let me first set up the UFW firewall, which will generate example logs for us. Feel free to choose any log file you prefer for monitoring instead of UFW. To begin adding your log file, navigate to the Logs section and access the Getting Started page. Then click Server. From there, you can select the specific source you wish to monitor. Since UFW is not listed as an option, you will need to choose Custom File instead. Once you have provided the necessary details such as the path, service and source of the log file on the configuration page, you will be presented with instructions on how to enable logging for that specific file. These instructions will guide you through the necessary steps to ensure that the log file is actively monitored by Datadog. To proceed with enabling logging for your custom file, you will need to create a new directory at etc datadogagent.conf.d if it doesn't already exist. Once the directory is created, you can copy the configuration provided on the page and paste it into a new file named conf.yaml within the sources directory. This configuration file will define the specific settings for monitoring your log file using the Datadog agent. Now let's proceed by restarting the Datadog agent to apply the changes made to the configuration. After restarting, we can check the status of the agent to ensure that it is running properly and that the new log file is being monitored. As shown, there appears to be an error indicating that the Datadog agent is unable to open the specified log file. To resolve this issue, you will need to install Access Control Lists (ACL) and grant the necessary permissions to the DD agent user for the log file. This will allow the agent to access and monitor the file successfully. After restarting the Datadog agent, you will see the logs displayed on your logs page. This page allows you to view and analyze logs from different sources and services across all of your hosts. However, since Datadog doesn't recognize the UFW source automatically, you need to manually add a pipeline for it and implement a parser. This will enable you to parse each log message into JSON format with specific fields. In the video, you will find step-by-step instructions on how to set up the pipeline and parsers for the UFW logs. As demonstrated, you can now observe event attributes by clicking on individual log records. This allows you to work with these attributes, such as filtering logs based on specific values or adding a new column to the log table. If you found this video helpful, please consider liking and subscribing to the channel for more content. Your support is greatly appreciated.